When we pull our trucks into a public hunting area the first day of the season, we don't think about wide open gates. We see the possibilities before us. When we walk through a stand of hardwood trees, we don't count the number of species we hear. The wild symphony stirs our souls. When we pull the trigger, it's not the end of a hunt. It's the beginning of a memory. For us, hunting isn't a hobby. It's a way of life. The outdoors isn't just what's on the other side of the glass. It's where we feel most alive. We are hunters. Conservationists. Volunteers. We are the National Wild Turkey Federation, the leader in upland conservation. Abundant wildlife, quality habitat, open access, hunting opportunities, all contribute to a great outdoors experience. Take one of them away, and more than just the hunt is in danger. Our lifestyle is threatened. The legacy we've built for the last four decades could crumble. But the National Wild Turkey Federation says, not on our watch, with its Save the Habitat, Save the Hunt initiative. The NWTF has designed a strategy based on its success with the wild turkey that will pivot our organization toward the future by emphasizing essential upland habitat conservation and creating new hunters. It's an aggressive 10-year charge that mobilizes science, fundraising, and our devoted volunteers. Not only to keep the NWTF mission alive, but to give it more power, more purpose than ever before. Our commitment for the coming decade? Raise $1.2 billion to conserve and enhance over 4 million acres of essential wildlife habitat. Create at least 1.5 million new hunters and open access to 500,000 new additional acres for hunting, shooting, and outdoor enjoyment. When it comes to our lifestyle, our legacy, what matters most to us, the NWTF is prepared to invest its time, resources, and elbow grease to ensure they're around tomorrow and forever. We lose 6,000 acres of critical habitat every day. That's 2.2 million acres a year, an area the size of Yellowstone National Park, gone every year. Wild turkey numbers have decreased by 15% nationally over the last several years, mostly due to lack of quality habitat. Hunters and our hunting rights are under constant attack. Hunting and habitat conservation go hand in hand. We can't have quality hunting without quality wildlife habitat. And the past has proven we won't have sustainable wildlife habitat unless hunters are involved. Hunters pay for 80% of the budgets for state wildlife agencies, which drive the research and work to restore essential habitat for game and non-game species. For the last 40 years, the NWTF mission has encompassed the conservation of the wild turkey and the preservation of our hunting heritage. Our mission hasn't changed, but times have. It's essential in these changing times to refocus and re-energize our efforts. When Tom Rogers founded the National Wild Turkey Federation in 1973, there were just over a million wild turkeys in the United States. He'd seen the research and witnessed it with his own eyes. Increases in human population and related development threatened wild turkey habitat. To restore wild turkeys to their historic numbers, Rogers knew he had to mobilize turkey hunters and their wallets to support research and restoration. Science-based research and education have remained mainstays of the NWTF and its mission. By 2004, the wild turkey had been reintroduced to 99% of suitable habitat, and we helped establish turkey hunting seasons in 49 states. We've reached those milestones, and now we must keep those habitats healthy for turkeys, or all our effort could be lost forever. Science has proven the upland habitat management we do for wild turkeys benefits other wildlife species as well. And the NWTF's conservation team has proven themselves experts in the field, leading landowners, government agencies, and grassroots volunteers to take on-the-ground action to achieve an unparalleled wildlife success story. In the last 40 years, the NWTF has invested more than $412 million to conserve 17.3 million acres of essential upland habitat to the benefit of game and non-game species. At a peak in 2005, nearly 7 million wild turkeys called North America home. And every year, the NWTF introduces 100,000 new men, women, and youth to the outdoors through its outreach efforts. These significant milestones were made possible by the NWTF's greatest resource, people. We want to harness the power of NWTF volunteers and partners by building on the legacy of our current success. The NWTF's Save the Habitat, Save the Hunt initiative will not only keep our mission on track for the next 10 years, it will focus our collective efforts, magnify our results, and make us more significant to hunters and wildlife conservation than ever before. This isn't business as usual. It's an aggressive initiative that will make a real difference to hunters and wildlife. Food, water, cover. The habitat portion of the Save the Habitat, Save the Hunt initiative focuses on-the-ground efforts on what matters most to wildlife. 4 habitat types meet these essential needs: forests, fields and meadows, river and stream corridors, and grasslands and shrublands. Each needs special attention to ensure they remain healthy against the ever-changing landscape. The NWTF has the know-how and manpower to make a positive impact on each type. Fields and meadows are essential for turkeys as soon as they hatch. It's necessary for their survival from egg to poult to adult. This type of habitat, also known as early successional habitat, is made of grasses and forbs that attract insects, the primary food source of young birds. Wild turkeys aren't the only wildlife that depends on fields and meadows. Many other species, such as the ruffed grouse, American woodcock, and New England cottontail, rely on the same vital upland habitat for survival. Every state wildlife agency in the Northeast has made active forest and field management as top conservation priorities. Nowhere more so than New York, where wild turkey populations are at a 20-year low. The decline is largely due to adverse weather and the loss of fields and meadows. We can't control the weather, but we can make a difference by actively managing habitat. Since 74% of the Northeast is privately owned, it's important the NWTF educates landowners on the positive impacts of habitat improvements, including better recreational opportunities and improved water quality. Eastern wild turkeys and bobwhite quail share the fields of the South. Today, you're lucky if you even hear the call of the bobwhite quail, a sound as distinctive as a southern accent. Its voice is almost a distant echo in central Georgia, where quail once thrived. Bobwhite quail populations in the South have declined 65% in the last 20 years. This trend is an indicator that the habitat isn't healthy, and other wildlife that depend on this type of habitat, like wild turkeys, are sure to follow. We've already witnessed a 7% decline in the eastern subspecies. It's a trend that can only be reversed with active management, increasing the quality of existing habitat amid an ever-changing landscape. And more suitable habitat means more quail and a better outlook for turkeys. The NWTF is knee-deep in grassland and shrubland management in Missouri's Dunn Ranch. It's a 5,000-acre property managed by the Nature Conservancy and represents one of the last restorable tall grass prairies in the Midwest. Turkeys may shy away from the vast open grasslands, but instead stick to the periphery to nest and raise their broods in safety. The Pawnee Prairie of the Dunn Ranch is one of the most imperiled habitats on the globe, even more so than the rainforests of South America. The NWTF is on site helping the Nature Conservancy convert this critical area back to native warm season grasses and keeping invasive and non-native vegetation at bay. Thanks to our efforts, this high-quality grassland is showing promising results, producing more turkeys now than it has in years. The next challenge is to increase the size and health of this last remaining block of tall grass prairie. North American forest management is not one size fits all. The NWTF's Save the Habitat, Save the Hunt initiative recognizes this. But one thing is constant. Wherever the compass needle points, finding balance between forest health and human existence is crucial. The fresh air and life-giving waters of Fish Lake and Dixie National Forests have drawn people to the heart of Utah since before recorded time. Miriam's wild turkeys, mule deer, and elk roam the aspen and ponderosa pine-laden habitat. Habitat that has been ravaged by wildfire in recent years. Wildfires are destroying western forests at an all-time high. These uncontrolled fires strip away vegetation, making areas susceptible to flood runoff, ruining fragile river ecosystems. Wildfires are also devastating to humans, destroying property, and in some cases, lives. NWTF biologists are working with state and federal organizations to manage western forests, fighting fire with fire, so to speak. Periodic sustainable burns and thinning timber keep wildfires in check and the forest understory healthy for wildlife. Aquatic species have clean water. Everyone can breathe easier, knowing the NWTF has stepped up and taken control. North America is covered in a complex network of rivers and streams that are the lifeblood of wildlife, humans, and agriculture. The Canadian River runs through western Oklahoma and the Texas Panhandle. It is home to Rio Grande wild turkeys and a favored destination of turkey hunters. The cottonwood is its benchmark tree, serving as the dominant roosting spot for wild turkeys. However, the cottonwood has its fair share of competition, and it's not healthy. Areas along the Canadian River have become choked with invasive trees such as eastern red cedar, salt cedar, and Russian olive. An acre of these unwanted species can suck up water from the river at a rate of 326,000 gallons per year. Since 2007, the NWTF has leveraged hundreds of thousands of dollars to remove invasive vegetation along the river, restoring 8,300 acres at an investment of $906,000 and restored habitat value for turkeys and endangered species. But we're just getting started. These wild turkey roost spots and wild turkeys could disappear completely in 25 years if drastic steps aren't made to kick out the invasive competition. Wild turkeys aren't the only beneficiaries. Removing invasive trees increases water quality, what's available for ranching and crop irrigation, and reduces the likelihood of wildfire. The proactive habitat management we've begun is only possible if someone foots the bill. That's why hunter recruitment is another vital part of the NWTF's Save the Habitat, Save the Hunt initiative. The NWTF has spent the last two decades introducing people to the outdoors. Our outreach efforts bring the outdoors and shooting to 100,000 people each year. But that's not enough. It's time we refocused our efforts in recruiting and retaining hunters to counteract the long-term decline in hunter numbers. We will reach our goal of recruiting 1.5 million new hunters. But introducing them to the shooting sports is only the beginning. The NWTF's Save the Habitat, Save the Hunt initiative will arm our volunteers with the tools they need to not only educate the public, it will help create hunters. It's a multi-part plan that not only introduces people to the outdoors, but gets them into hunter education and into the field on mentored hunts. In turn, we will build our forces to fight for our lifestyle, our legacy. Our voice will ring louder as we emerge as the conservation group who champions hunting and hunters' rights. But it's difficult to recruit and keep hunters when there aren't places to hunt. Lack of access is among the top reasons people give for not hunting. With 6,000 acres of habitat lost each day and 35 million acres of federal land not accessible to the public, it can seem like too grand a challenge for an individual to overcome. The NWTF's Save the Habitat, Save the Hunt initiative has a goal to increase hunter access to 500,000 acres. It's a threefold approach. Work with wildlife agency partners to provide access to state and federal lands. Help hunters gain access to private lands. And acquire key lands for conservation and hunting. The NWTF and our volunteers understand why this is important and believe we're on the right path. Abundant wildlife, quality habitat, open access, hunting opportunities, all contribute to a great outdoors experience. That's why the NWTF's Save the Habitat, Save the Hunt initiative is critical for the future. We will raise $1.2 billion to conserve and enhance 4 million acres, create at least 1.5 million hunters, and open access to 500,000 new acres. We have the right plan. Now it's up to us to take action. Our goal might seem lofty to some, but we've seen the passion and determination of NWTF volunteers. We have partners unmatched in their commitment to what's right. We have stuck to science, produced results, and proven ourselves as the upland conservation leader in the last 40 years. we have already completed more than 50,000 projects on behalf of our mission. It's time we focused our efforts for the future of conservation. What will you do to help save the habitat and the hunt?